People are promoting oral collagen supplements all over the internet for their hair, skin, and nail benefits. But do they work? In this video, I'm going to dive deep into the science behind collagen supplements, whether you should take them, what to look out for if you do decide to buy them, and at the end, I'll reveal whether it's something I take. Because if you're new here, I'm Maria and I'm a registered dietitian. Welcome to the channel. Every day, thousands of influencers promote collagen supplements for their beauty benefits. And it's very convincing that you need to buy these to fit a certain wellness image. But they are expensive, about $50 US for 1 month's supply. And to put that into perspective, that is $600 US a year. So for me, I would really want to know that I'm getting bang for buck with these supplements. Or else I prefer to spend my money elsewhere, like on some nice skincare or good facials. And over the last few years, there has been a lot of research into these collagen supplements. So thankfully, we do have a lot more evidence to consider. Now, before we talk about collagen supplements, I think it's a good idea to get a grasp on collagen itself. That way we can make a more informed decision about whether there's something that we want to take. So collagen is the main structural protein within our connective tissue. So it's in our skin, bones, cartilage, and even in our eyes. But unfortunately, as we age, our bodies make less collagen, and the collagen that we have starts to break down. From the age of 20, we start to lose about 1% of collagen in our skin every year. And after menopause, falling estrogen levels lead to a further decline in collagen production. So you are always building collagen within your body and rebuilding it throughout your life cycle. And when it comes to collagen in the skin, that breakdown can be expedited by external factors as well, like UV radiation from the sun. And as these levels drop over time, our skin begins to lose its elasticity, which results in the skin losing its bounce and becoming more susceptible to wrinkle formation. So it makes a lot of sense that people would want to hold on to their collagen, but also increase their ability to make new collagen going forward. So I totally understand the appeal of collagen supplements, because we go to a lot of effort with our skin topically, like using retinoids and protecting ourselves from the sun. But if we could take something in an easy supplement form, that would help collagen throughout your whole body, wouldn't that be pretty amazing? Now, the first thing to note about oral collagen supplements is that they do not exist as full collagen molecules, because collagen molecules are really big, so it's hard for your body to digest and break them down. Instead, that oral collagen supplement is processed into what we call hydrolyzed collagen, where they've taken the large collagen chain and broken it down into peptides, or even smaller components called amino acids. Next, I think it's important to understand that oral collagen supplements are not vegan. They're all derived from animals. So if you hear something about vegan collagen supplements, that is not a thing right now. Granted, in the future, there will probably be some bioengineering thing that happens. But for now, all the collagen supplements available in the market are animal derived. Most commonly, collagen supplements are derived from bovine sources, such as cows, and marine sources, such as fish. But you can also get collagen from pigs and chickens. Finally, our bodies naturally produce collagen if we give them the building blocks to do so, like sufficient amino acids from protein-rich foods and vitamin C to support with the collagen building process. So we don't necessarily need to eat collagen as long as we're eating enough protein. And I have a full video here on how much protein you should be eating if you want to learn more. Now I'm gonna pause here and ask that if you're enjoying the video so far, I would really appreciate it if you hit the red subscribe button below. It really helps support my channel so I can continue making more videos like this one. And while you're at it, I would love it if you gave the video a thumbs up too. So the concept that oral collagen supplements, when consumed, can be deposited into the skin is somewhat flawed. Remember, I said that collagen is a very big molecule, so it would be hard for it to get into the skin as it is. And when we eat proteins, they are digested and broken down into individual amino acids, which are absorbed into the bloodstream to be used by the body wherever they are needed. We can't direct them to go to the skin. Now, the studies are showing that these collagen peptides are present in the blood of the people who take them, but it's still unclear if they're getting to the skin to serve as building blocks for this collagen, or whether they're simply being distributed throughout the whole body. Instead, what seems to be happening when you take these supplements is that the hydrolyzed collagen essentially acts like a signaling molecule, and it wakes up your fibroblasts, which are collagen-producing cells in your skin, and it causes them to make more collagen. So it's not the collagen getting deposited there that really has the benefit, but rather that the collagen acts as a prompt for your body to make more collagen. Now, this hasn't been rigorously proven, but it's the current working theory as to how these work and why it's so specific to the hydrolyzed collagen peptide. Do the collagen supplements work? Well, these large studies that I mentioned at the start of the video, they look at all of the data and they come up with specific conclusions based on this. And overall, the findings suggest that hydrolyzed oral collagen supplements do have positive effects on the skin. Almost every study conducted noted some kind of positive effect. So the research is really promising. And based on this, I can completely understand why somebody would want to buy these. However, I do want to point out a few things. First is all of this research that we have on collagen supplements to date is nearly completely done by collagen supplement companies. So that in itself is something to be very mindful of. Next, the current data is not standardized. All of the studies use different type of collagen peptides, different sources or different brands. They report on different outcomes and the duration of use can differ widely too. So the overall conclusions drawn are not the highest quality. And in some of the studies, it's also unclear if the skin benefits were directly related to collagen, because some of the supplements also included different vitamins, minerals, and antioxidants, and even hyaluronic acid, which could also have been impacting the skin. You're also going to be improving your general protein intake by taking these supplements, which in itself can improve the skin. Keep an eye out for this video here to learn more about my 5 nutrition principles for lovely glowing skin. Now, a few randomized controlled trials show that drinking collagen supplements with specific peptides can improve skin moisture, elasticity, wrinkles, and roughness. But large, high-quality studies are needed to learn whether commercially available products are helpful and safe to use long-term. We also don't know to what extent everyone benefits from these. Is it more mature skin? Does the dose vary by age? Are the liquid, capsules, or gummies best? We really don't know, and there is a lot of variability. I'm quite neutral. I understand people wanting to take them because there is research behind them, but I wouldn't be pushing people to run out the door and purchase these yet either. It's really quite an individual choice and depends where you are financially, what your goals are, and what you prioritize. I know some people just love anything to do with the skin and will be more than happy to experiment with these. Now, the good news is that oral collagen seems to be very well tolerated. The biggest side effects reported with these supplements seem to be related to the gut, such as stomach pain or diarrhea. But again, it's quite small. If you do have a sensitive stomach, you might want to start with a smaller dose and then work your way up. So I would say that collagen supplements are safe for most people. Now, they haven't been tested on those who are pregnant or breastfeeding, so I would speak to your GP if you fall within that group. My main concern is that nutritional supplements are not regulated, so they're not always subject to the same scrutiny and oversight as regulated drugs. So one thing that I would look for when picking out or choosing a supplement is one that is third-party tested. You can also look out for the Informed Sport logo or the NSF Certified Sport logo. When a supplement is third-party tested, this means that another unbiased group has tested that collagen to really prove that what is on the label is actually what's in the supplement. Because I would say the biggest risk here is choosing a supplement, which may include things that are not disclosed on the label, as many dietary supplements have been found to be adulterated with contaminants. For example, recently enough, the tennis player Simona Halep failed a drug test. They found out that the collagen supplement she was taking contained undisclosed banned substances. Another criticism of these supplements is that they can be contaminated with heavy metals. Now, the vast majority of the time, the heavy metals that are detected in collagen supplements are not at a level where they would cause harm to human health, but they're present nonetheless. And that's honestly unavoidable when it comes to making a collagen supplement, because they are derived from other animals who have lived in the world. So there's always going to be a little bit of heavy metal presence in these supplements, but it should be low or very close to zero. However, where things start to get a little bit more dodgy is when multiple servings get consumed in a day. So always abide by the manufacturing guidelines. Now, some frequently asked questions about these supplements. Can they work for hair and nails? So I would be a lot more skeptical of collagen claims for hair and nails, because hair and nails are mainly made from keratin, not collagen. Now, there is a lot of anecdotal evidence of people claiming that these supplements have helped with their hair and nails, but it may just be that you are slightly improving your protein intake by taking these supplements. And that is probably what is helpful, because when I see a patient who is protein deficient, it's often their hair and nails that are really suffering. Now, there's one small study showing improvements with nails, but again, it was a poor study with no control group. And there's currently no medical evidence that supports marketing claims that collagen supplements can improve hair growth, shine, volume, and thickness. But if you've been taking these supplements and you have noticed improvements in your nails or hair, please let me know in the comments below. I would be very interested to hear. Now, can I just eat bone broth? So not for this desired outcome. So the amino acids that tend to be particularly beneficial in these collagen supplements are glycine, proline, and hydroxyproline. And these are the ones that you want to look out for in terms of improving your skin. but the concentrations of these are very low in bone broth in comparison to the collagen supplements. Bone broth, if it's something that you enjoy, by all means, you can continue to take it. But I do think a lot of the wellness accounts overhype the benefits of bone broth. And the nutrients in bone broth, they vary tremendously. It's going to vary based on the animal, the age of the animal, and the preparation methods. So just keep that in mind because the wellness advocates love to oversell. Now, can you use collagen supplements as a protein powder? So you can, they will contain some protein, but it will vary greatly depending on the brand. Some brands will only provide 5 grams of protein per serving, whereas a traditional protein powder will often provide around 20 to 30 grams of protein per serving. So if you're really struggling with your protein intake, you're probably better off going for a protein powder. Also, if you are deciding to take the collagen supplement as a replacement for protein powder, it also won't contain all the essential amino acids. So you may be better off with something else. Make sure to watch my protein video to understand this a little bit better. And it is really important for your skin to make sure that you are getting enough protein. Now, can I take collagen supplements if I have haemochromatosis? So yes, I do think you can. But I would try to choose one that does not have vitamin C added into it. Now, if you can't find one or you have one that you really like that does contain vitamin C, it's probably okay. Just don't be taking it at the same time as any other iron-containing food. Now, as a dietitian, do I take collagen? So currently I don't, but after doing all of the research into this video, I am a lot more tempted. I did also recently get engaged, so I really want to start upping my skincare in preparation for the big day. However, I just recently added a topical retinoid and vitamin C to my skincare regimen. So I want to give these some time to work first. That way, if I do start taking a collagen supplement, I'll be able to more clearly pinpoint if I can see a difference in my skin from specifically taking the supplement. And this is a good approach to take because that way you can rationalize whether or not it's working and whether or not you should continue to keep buying it. If I do start taking collagen supplements, let me know in the comments below if it is something you'd like me to make a video about. Now, if I do decide to take them, or if you, after watching this video, want to take them, there is a couple of things that I would definitely look out for. So I would pick either bovine or marine collagen. It seems that these are the best tested forms of collagen and seem to exert the best benefits. I would choose a supplement that contains type 1 collagen, as this is what's found in the skin. And with dipeptides such as proline hydroxyproline or hydroxyproline glycine, as these appear to show faster clinical results in trials. And also make sure you're consuming enough vitamin C and vitamin E to support your body building this collagen. You need to make sure the supplement is third-party tested. And of course, it has to taste good if you're gonna have to drink it every day. And I would take the supplement for at least 8 weeks, ideally 12 weeks, to really be able to evaluate if it's working. Dose-wise, you want a minimum of 2.5 grams per serving. So overall, I think we need more studies and larger studies. The more information we have, the more informed decisions we can make. So if you've ever tried these oral collagen supplements, let me know in the comments below how it has been going for you. Have you seen benefits in your skin, in your hair, or in your nails? And is there a specific brand that you particularly like? Now keep an eye out for next week's video, which is going to be my 5 nutrition and skin principles that you need to be implementing in order to ensure you have lovely glowing skin. And thank you so much for watching. As a thank you for making it all the way to the end, I have a free recipe ebook, which I'll link in the description box below. I hope you found this video helpful. Don't forget to subscribe, stay happy and healthy, and I'll see you again next week. Thanks for watching.